Landing on Mars is easier said than done. Over the last 50 years, spacecraft have landed on more than half a dozen worlds, including Venus, Saturn's moon Titan, a comet, and more. But nowhere has proven more treacherous than the red planet, Mars. To date, only 40% of attempted landings have been successful. But just looking at it, Mars seems pretty harmless, right? It doesn't have toxic clouds like Venus, and there's plenty of flat, stable places to land, unlike a comet. But here's the thing, it's not what you can see that's the problem. It's what you can't. It's the atmosphere. Mars's atmosphere is 100 times thinner than Earth's. Because Mars's atmosphere is so thin, it makes parachutes less effective. 10 times less effective, in fact. So let's say you could skydive on Mars, and let's use the same size parachute as one you would use on Earth. On Earth, skydiver's chutes slow them down to about 20 miles per hour. But on Mars, even with the parachute, you would still be falling at 200 miles per hour, which obviously is not good. Now you could make your parachute larger and slow down even more, and that's partly what NASA does. For example, its Curiosity rover used the largest supersonic parachute at the time when it landed in 2012. But even that couldn't slow Curiosity down enough. To see why, let's go back to the skydiving. If you wanted to slow down at the same landing speed on Mars as on Earth, you would need a parachute that's 10 times wider, or about 110 feet in diameter, wide enough to cover the length of 2.5 school buses. Now, here's the catch. NASA's Curiosity rover weighs about 13 times more than the average person, which means to slow down at the same speed, it would need an even bigger chute. One that is about, 400 feet in diameter. But in reality, Curiosity's parachute was nowhere near that size. It was only 70 feet in diameter. Why? Because the bigger the chute gets, the greater chance it will rip. In fact, the largest parachute ever built and tested was just 150 feet wide. So in the end, it's physically impossible to build a parachute big enough, which makes landing on Mars risky at best. So how do space agencies do it? Well, very carefully. First, the spacecraft deploys a giant parachute to slow down as much as possible, usually around 200 miles per hour. Then it fires retro rockets to take it the rest of the way. And that might not sound so hard, but if the parachute doesn't deploy at just the right time, or the rockets don't fire at just the right height, it's all over. To date, only 3 space agencies have ever tried to land on Mars. NASA, the European Space Agency, and the former Soviet Union. None have a perfect record. So if landing on Mars is so hard, why do we keep doing it in the first place? Besides the moon, Mars has more artificial instruments on and around it than anywhere else in our solar system. And you could say that's because Mars is close by, or that it might be the best spot to search for signs of alien life. Or it could be that with each successful new landing, we come one step closer to the grandest ambition of all: to become the first species ever to inhabit a world beyond our own.